making God's will as our will is the best choice. Greetings to you in the precious name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Welcome to the 27th day of a journey from wilderness to Calvary. My brothers and sisters, today we celebrate one of the most famous and great feast in the liturgical calendar, the Feast of Saint Joseph. When we read the Bible, we do not get any details about Joseph. Well, we get very few details about Jesus, Joseph, the father of Jesus. How he was betrothed to Mary, and then how he took care of Jesus. But we don't find any word spoken by Joseph. Saint Joseph seems to be a silent man, yet there are so many beautiful things that we can take up from his life. You know, the Bible says that he's from a noble lineage. But nothing was noble in his life. He was a poor carpenter, very insignificant, not known much. And he was also taking care of a simple family. And he was always communicated with the dreams. And we all know that today's gospel also says that he wanted to give up on the responsibility that was given to him to take Mary as his wife. And that too for a reason, that he doesn't want Mary to be in shame, Mother Mary not to be in shame. Well, my dear brothers and sisters, we have this Joseph tuning his will to the will of God. No doubt, Joseph might have had a lot of dreams about his own marriage, his life, his career, his children, but he had to give up all that for the will of God, for the sake of the plan of God. And that's how Saint Joseph completely tunes himself according to the will of God. Like Abraham, who completely surrendered his life to God. Abraham was told by God that to sacrifice his only son. And without any say, he just blindly obeys it and goes to the extent of sacrificing his son. And therefore, he was attributed as the father of faith. And we have much more greater than Abraham is Joseph, a simple, humble man with noble character, took care, formed Jesus, molded Jesus, and he prepared to save all of us. Today, as we celebrate this great feast of Saint Joseph, as Pope Francis says, that every day, whatever the problem that I have, I place my problems underneath the statue of a sleeping Joseph, because he dreams about it, about my problem, and then he thinks about my problem and he solves my problem. My dear brothers and sisters, he says that every problem which was addressed to Joseph was answered. Therefore, we have this powerful saint, Saint Joseph, of which we also celebrate this year as Year of Joseph, which was announced by Pope Francis. Let's all approach and seek his intercession to help all of us to do the will of God as he did in his life, to tune ourselves to the plan of God. If you like this small piece of reflection, kindly share, like, and contribute to the promotion of this channel. God bless you and have a wonderful day.